Hallelujah, and welcome to the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. We are in a season of resurrection, and we are so excited about the opportunity God has given to us to pray at the steps of the Georgia State Capitol, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. We want to wait on the Lord for this nation, for our state, for our cities, for our families, for those that are hurting, for the unemployed. We understand the mystery in 2 Chronicles 7:14, that if we humble ourselves before the Lord and repent of our sins and turn from our wicked ways and pray, beloved, He promises to hear our prayer, to forgive our sins, and to heal our land. Beloved, it only takes a remnant to get this done. Church affiliation really doesn't matter. Who is leading it doesn't matter. What matters is that we are God's people. We believe in Jesus, and we are concerned about this nation, and we believe in the power of prayer, that God can answer our prayer. God will change the face of our nation through intercession and prayer. And of course, we will have the resurrection parade. We went from Easter to resurrection parade. That's the evening, the day before Easter. And we'll parade through downtown, and we'll have a great rally to bless the Lord and to exalt His name, so we will know that Jesus came out of that grave for you. That's what our ministry this week is all about, that God will cause the resurrection power, the glory that raised up Jesus, to manifest in our lives. I want to show you the conflict. I want to show you the opposition, so you can understand what is happening in your own life, so you will determine that the power of resurrection will take hold in your life, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So join me as we read Matthew chapter 27, verse 62. The Bible says, "Now the next day that followed the day of the preparation, the chief priests and Pharisees came together unto Pilate, saying, Sir, we remember that that deceiver said while he was yet alive, after 3 days I will rise again. Command therefore that the sepulchre be made sure until the third day, lest his disciples come by night and steal him away, and say unto the people, he is risen from the dead. So the last error shall be worse than the first. Pilate said unto them, you have a watch. Go your way, make it as sure as you can. So they went and made the sepulchre sure, sealing the stone and setting a watch." Beloved, everything that happens in the life of the Lord Jesus is the same battle you and I are facing. He left us an example to follow His steps. Every time God makes you a promise, the moment you mention it, hell will unleash everything in their power to stop it. But beloved, if the word is from God, it will still come to pass. Whether the opposition is fierce or mild, the word of the Lord shall prevail. The Bible said the word of the Lord is not bound. Yes, we may be bound in one way or the other, but the word of the Lord is not bound. And when we hold on to the word of God, it will liberate us. Jesus told the people, if you kill me, 3 days later, I will rise again. The people thought that when they killed him, that he was finished. I want you to listen to me carefully this week, beloved, because many of you have been wounded, rejected, felt forsaken of God, because those that criticized you or judged you seem to have won, and they're gloating over you, and you are frustrated, and you are in pain. But beloved, I want you to remember that, again, what happened with Jesus will happen in your life. That before God shows His power, He always allows the enemy to gloat. Don't be frustrated. Don't be rejected. Don't hate the people. God is setting you up for resurrection power. Hallelujah. They mocked Jesus. They celebrated his downfall. They thought they were done with him. And all of a sudden a thought comes to them. He said he will resurrect. And they went to Pilate and said, let us make sure that this man does not resurrect. Let's secure the tomb. Let's make sure that his disciples will not come and steal him away. And beloved, they secured it, and they were so sure, beloved, that he will not get out of that grave. And I'm telling you, the enemy is so sure that you will not come through. The enemy is so sure you will not get healed. The enemy is so sure you will not prosper. The enemy is so sure. But beloved, the resurrection morning is on the way. And as we will see in our text, and as we study for the next 2 weeks, you will see the glory of God made manifest in your life as he was made manifest in the life of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Isn't that good news? Before you leave to go to work this morning, start celebrating your victory, your resurrection, even before you see it. The Lord loves you, and we do too. We will see you tomorrow. God bless you.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.